Does a higher body fat percentage imply laziness? Many would say yes. However, I'm here to argue the contrary. I want to offer you a different perspective. So, I first want to bring to your attention that when you are in a caloric surplus or a higher body fat percentage, let us assume 15-20%, you're not overly lean. Maybe you got a little bit of abs showing, but overall, you're fluffy. Guess what? You have greater recovery. In fact, there's a reason why they say eat big to get a big bench. It's true. When you're eating a lot of food, you're putting all the stuff into your body, you recover better. Now, if you recover better, what does that mean? Well, it means that you can train more frequently, you can train with more intensity, more volume, and overall, you can put more effort into the physical work. That's just a fact. Everybody who goes on a bulk, their performance goes up, 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 up. When you're in a caloric deficit, your performance goes down, 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 or you at least maintain it. Point is, when you eat a lot of food, when you eat big to get big, you get very strong in the process and your effort in the gym goes up tremendously. Therefore, from a work ethic perspective, you're not being lazy. You're being the precise opposite. In fact, I want to ask you guys a question. Would you say that Eddie Hall is lazy? He's probably like 40% body fat or more. Would you say that Half Thor is lazy? Would you say that Brian Shaw is lazy? All these elite guys. How about the top powerlifters that weigh 250 pounds, 300, who are a bit on the fluffier side? Are they lazy? Actually, you want to know a fun fact, and I learned this from Omar Yusuf. Apparently, the best powerlifters are in a fluffy state. Like, they're not overly lean. They're not shredded. They're usually, like, between 12-15% body fat because they get better performance out of it. So, you know what? Just because they're not shredded, bruh, they're not shredded, just because they don't have the aesthetics, quote-unquote, doesn't make them lazy. In fact, it's the opposite because they could work out hard in the gym, especially on a Bulgarian program. If you're not eating on a high-frequency program, it's going to bury you to the ground. So the only argument that we could really say when we talk about laziness is diet. Laziness of diet, because you enjoy eating junk food, you enjoy eating garbage, you just don't want to nail your food on point. You know what? That is true to a certain extent. We all know of the stereotypical powerlifter who eats out on a consistent basis. You know, you see these guys doing their vlogs, eating their garbage foods. A lot of them are fat as hell. They got terrible blood markers. These people exist. However, it's not the majority. And even if that's true, there's still a way to be fluffy without being lazy. For example, clean eating. If your diet is on point, but you're in a caloric surplus or in a caloric maintenance at a higher body fat, nothing lazy about that. If you're actually calculating your caloric needs, you're calculating your macros, all that good stuff, nothing lazy about it. Nothing at all. Because you're actively tracking what you do. And in fact, I can even flip this around by saying that because you're ingesting all this food, you have to go to a grocery store more often. Guys, you ever see Brian Shaw go to Costco? He eats like 6 pounds of meat a day. Watch what he did. He spent like $500 and he says that he eats that in 5 days. So watch these bodybuilders and strongmen go out to eat. Do you think that's lazy? Do you think it's lazy doing all this meal prep? Being a freaking chef? I bet Brian Shaw, man, I bet if you go to his house, he's going to make you a damn good meal. I bet he knows how to make some good steaks because he's cooking all the time. It was the same thing for me. When I was bulking, I was eating all the goddamn day. All the time. Like every 2-3 hours, you're having these big ass meals and you feel bloated and stuffed all the time. And you got to really brush up on your cooking game, man, because if your cooking's not on point, you're not going to eat as much food. You're going to be in a caloric deficit and you're going to start losing weight. So especially for hard gainers, it's not laziness, it's the opposite. I'll tell you what's lazy for me. Waking up in the morning, having some coffee, fasting throughout the day, 6 o'clock, I eat a big meal. That's lazy. You know what's not lazy? Waking up, eating a meal when you're not hungry, when you're like, ugh. Then a few hours later, you're eating more meals, more meals, more meals, more meals, more meals, till you go to bed. And you gotta cook the fucking thing too. That's hard work, boys. That's hard work. So yeah, we can argue all day. Oh, appetite. Well, there's other factors we gotta account for, okay? And of course, don't take this discussion so black and white. I'm just offering a different perspective. And then the final point that I like to give up is that aesthetics are subjective. And whatever your goals may be, if you're actively trying to pursue them, there's no laziness involved. For instance, when I was bear mode for all those years, it was 100% my own pursuit. There was nothing lazy about bear mode. In fact, it was the opposite. It was a very tough thing to do. Right now, I'm 160 pounds. Been maintaining this for about a month or so. Easiest thing in the world. I'm not even counting calories. Just eating according to natural appetite. In bear mode, I had to force feed, okay? And it's what I wanted. I wanted the higher body fat for the superhuman recovery. to look as big as possible in clothes, to just have that massive frame without drugs. It was my objective. And I would argue the same for all these strongman competitors. They know that they're in a fatter state. They know that they're fluffy, but it's what they want to succeed. You think Eddie Hall can't get shredded if he wants to? Of course he can. He was a competitive swimmer back in the day. Eddie Hall does what he does because he's the best. And to be the best at strongman, you gotta have that bigger frame. All these strongman competitors are not shredded. They're fluffy. They do it for a reason. These powerlifters who gain weight for competition, who gain weight to improve their bench, they're trying to excel at whatever they're trying to do. You know what I'm saying? So the more weight you have, the better. That's why weight classes exist. So when people are actively trying to pursue a certain goal and it's what they want, it is their vision, that's not lazy. It's lazy to the whole aesthetics bra guy. If your mindset is so like narrow-minded that to you, the only thing that matters is how ripped your abs are, you're a fool. You're a fool because you're discrediting everything else that exists, all the other forms of sport. Did you know that the bodybuilding world is the only place on the planet where people think you're fat? Like, if you're 15%, 12-15%, no one's gonna call you out for being fat. You're gonna have washboard, you might have some physical, visible six-pack abs. But in the bodybuilding world, if you're not shredded to the bone, you're a lazy fat ass, which is crazy. That's absolute madness. That's what I'm saying. We have these crazy standards. It's all about aesthetics all the time, and people discard the fact that we have individual goals, and if you're pursuing those goals, there's no laziness involved in that. So if you want to be bear mode, if you want to be a bit fluffier, if this is your choice, if you're doing what you need to do to succeed in your sport, if this is your aesthetic belief, no laziness whatsoever, because it's what you want, and it's all subjective. So those are my three counter-arguments to what some people like to say, oh, it's lazy when you're fluffy. It's not. In fact, this winter, I'm probably gonna go bear mode again, and I can assure you that it's not gonna be hard. For one, I'm gonna have to be training much harder, okay? Because right now, when you're leaner, your recovery's not as good. So I'm gonna have to train much harder, I'm gonna have to cook a lot more meals, I'm gonna become a goddamn chef. And also, it's like force feeding. So I'm getting ready for that this winter, okay? But right now, I'm gonna enjoy the summer gains. So, hope you enjoyed the segment. Give me feedback down below, and I'll talk to you all next time.